Hey there, my name is Joshua Migadde and I've been creating motion graphics in After Effects for quite a while. Today we are going to be creating text stroke animation without using trim paths, all in After Effects. Let's dive right in. First of all, I'm going to create a new composition. And that composition, I'm going to call it text stroke. After that, I'm going to create a new text layer. I'm going to click up there and create a text called stroke, and I'm going to make sure it's in the center. What I'll do is I'm going to use one of my tools up there, pan behind anchor tool. I'm going to move my anchor all the way to the center, roughly to the center, and then I'll come all the way to align and make sure it's in the center. After doing all this, I'm going to go to effects and presets and add an effect called Vegas. I'm going to drag it directly on top of the text. And after adding Vegas, I'm going to make sure that in my image contours, my input layer is the text stroke. My channel is alpha. Channel over there, my channel is alpha. And my threshold is 127, which is fine over there. I'm going to go all the way down to segments and I'm going to change it to 1. After changing my segments to 1, I'm going to come to my width and put it on any number that I want. I would say 18. And then I'll change the blend mode from over to transparent. That will make the text come on top, the stroke come on top of the words and make it transparent, as you can see over there. Where the word was originally is now transparent. I can change the color to white. I'm going to use white for now. And I'm going to change my hardness to 0.5. After changing my hardness to 0.5, I'm going to set my start opacity to 1 and my end opacity to 1. So all I have to do is come over here and change the length. I'm going to keyframe the length. I'm going to go all the way at the beginning and I'm going to drag it all the way down to 0. I'm going to go, let's say 20 frames. I'm going to change it all the way to 1. That will give me the stroke animation that you see over there. I'm going to switch this to a quarter and we are going to try to preview this. When I preview it, it's giving me that, but it's too fast. So I'll press U on my keyboard and it's going to show me the current keyframes that I have in that layer. I'm going to move this all the way in front so that it's not as fast. And that's how you achieve the stroke effect. What you can also do is that if you see over here, the words start in a uniform kind, the stroke starts in a uniform way. We are going to turn on random phase. Turning on random phase will randomly choose places for where the stroke should start and then it will end all at once. So that's how you achieve the trim path kind of animation without actually using trim paths. The beauty with that is I can change the text from stroke all the way to text. I can capitalize that by clicking over here. Can change it all the way to text and I will still have my stroke animation and I'm not using trim paths at all. So that's how you create text animation. That's how you create a stroke animation without actually using trim paths. This method, I found it to be way simpler and way faster other than creating shapes from the text and then using trim paths in that shape layer. The issue with that method is that I don't have the flexibility of changing my text. Every time I need to change my text, I'll have to go back and when I change the text, I have to go back and create shapes from text. So using this method is easier and it's beautiful because I can still change color. I still have the flexibility I had before. Can change my color from color over there. Can increase my hardness or something. Change my width just like you could earlier before. And that's how you create stroke text animation without actually using trim paths. Thank you for watching this tutorial. And if you're interested in text animations like this, I have created 13 text animation presets that you can use natively in Premiere Pro and in After Effects. The links will be down in the description below. We'll see you next time.